There we go. So we'll come on up.
Okay. Do you want me to grab this case of wine?
Yes, please. Oh, that's really good. I've been getting Ksenia to carry it for me.
I did think perhaps you shouldn't be.
Oh, I can do it, but I'm clumsy. Fortunately, Rachel came and got the carton of wine, so we don't have to carry it up. They're the leftover sparkly bottles.
French map.
Oh, yes.
Yes. It's, well, Helen, Rachel, you know, Helen, she makes very good mosaics. She's very talented.
It's not only yours, right? So it's from all of the places.
All over the place, yeah. Yep.
Mm.
All over the world.
How many bottles would be in there, right?
I think 2,000.
I need to do a lot of drinking.
Yeah. Keeps you busy.
And the alcohol?
Anyone
can come?
Yep. Yeah. As long as they drink, as long as they drink and buy the booze. And tell you what, they enjoy it.
It was a horrible day though. It was windy and hot and there was a bushfires out in the
That's right. Yeah. Yes.
So 12 o'clock we opened the gates. And as we did, when you look down that way, there's this big black plume of smoke. And it's just like... And then they send out warning messages to your phone. The first message we got, if you haven't evacuated, it's too late. You must remain where you are. That was the first message we got. No, there's a watch and act. It was, if you haven't gone, it's too late.
Did it affect the people coming?
There was a few people that didn't turn up.
Yeah.
Whether it was for the weather or the bushfires, I don't know. But yeah, everybody that came went, "Oh, what are we meant to do?" I'm like, "Well, you're in our evacuation spot, so let's just wait and see. We're okay because the wind was blowing in the right direction, but it was a bit of a worry."
Well, this is Royal Freshwater Bay Yacht Club. It's fairly prestigious.
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah.
Daryl.
Sorry.
Looking at all of the hideously large revolting houses. The completely over the top houses. Yeah.
Yes, all of those. All very interesting.
Yes.
Well, there's a beautiful view on the at the River Swan. Margaret took me here to show a bit of a fancy life of Perth. They always do railway stations pretty. In Russia also. Mm-hmm. It could be.
Do you want a beer?
Yeah, why not?
Why not? We're here. There's a car park.
Oh, there. Okay.
So they get it made here.
Oh, вот они. Кеки.
Chin on a video.
Ira, я нашла тебя. That one speaks something. Come on.
Hello. This is Amber that you're meeting today. You're welcome to have a little feel of her fur just on her tail. She is a common brush-tailed possum.
Oh.
Possums are marsupials, like kangaroos, so they have a pouch and they give birth to super little joeys that then develop in their pouch.
So cute!
What about you? Do you want to?
Oh, beautiful! You see the joey there? You can't see the bulge, but you can't see the pouch.
Oh. So the patch is... Дори
Thank you. Levitavin.
Wow.
All right?
Yeah.
It's so good to see you. Ah, Mark, how was the trip?
Marvelous.
All of the way? That's the one.
Panda mate. How do I look?
Oh, very chic.
Yeah?
Look.
Oh, nice.
He blinked.
Soft. What is the snake?
This is a corn snake. So they're a North American species. Uh-huh. So not native to Australia.
And it's non-venomous, obviously.
Absolutely. I think I'd get in a bit of trouble if I brought a venomous one out for you.
I like it.
Very good.
I can feel its muscles.
Absolutely.
Lovely. Have a name?
It does, yes. What's his name?
George.
George. No, not George. That's one of the other ones. So the three corn snakes are called Bubble, Squeak and Pop. I couldn't tell you which one it is, but it's one of those three names.
Yes.
You need to
I'm taking photos.
Press the button.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah, just hold it. So when she jumps, move it out of the way like that, give her a bit of enrichment. And then on this, on the next one, you want to let her get it.
On the next one?
Yeah.
Oh, you've done well.
He's estimated to be 80.
80?
Yeah. Put it over his nose.
It's food. Oh, he's hard to fool.
Just waiting, he knows that.
Try and keep it still.
He's like, I don't care, I don't need it.
A little bit.
He's ready now.
He scared ya.
That was he was waiting for.
Get him.
Can't trick with that.
Look at this guy. Look at this guy.
Pops.
He's blind. He can't see.
Okay.
So when we sing out his name, he'll sit there with his mouth open.
You say he's blind?
Mm-hmm.
What happened to his eyes?
He was obviously fighting out the wild.
Already without eyes?
Yeah.
It's much better.
Come on.
He must be lonely.
Wow, someone took it. Wow, it's pretty cool.
Yes.
Yeah.
Come on, Nigel. Okay, you are okay.
She's cold.
Yeah? What does it feel like?
Like cold skin.
Can you turn around? It's a bit bright here. Thank you. And he's 2 years old?
Yep.
2 years old.
They could be all different sizes at 2 years old. They could be triple his size, they could be half his size. Okay. It just depends on how much food intake they're having.
He's breathing.
He's alive.
Yeah. thanks a lot. Wow.
Yeah. See all these little black dots on him?
Yeah.
That's how they pick up on how you're feeling.
Wow.
Mechanoreceptors.
What a selfie.
Yeah, I just wanted to get up and close with it.
That's good.
You feel his teeth?
Nah, I'm passing that one.
I need him so I could lift him up and undo the tape. But I don't know, it just ended up cutting me.
Wow.
Did you have to worry about disease and infection?
No. These guys can carry chlamydia.
Yeah.
But they can carry it genitally or they can carry it in their eyes and mouth. Once they get it in their eyes and mouth, they end up dying from it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
They can get cancer, they can get blood disease, they can get a lot of stuff we get. We've just actually had to put down one of our crocodiles because he had cancer. We noticed that he had all these little balls on his skin, and then we noticed that he stopped eating and stopped being active, and that was like a key factor. And then close inspection, we noticed that he had them all on his underbelly, all going down the top of his tail, and he had them all around underneath his jawline. So we ended up putting him down, euthanizing him, and then we dissected him and we realized that he was on the inside of his body was just riddled with
was
cancer.
It really?
Yeah.
Soft, isn't it?
Yeah.
To borrow his handbag.
No way. Billy's feet.
That's just so, yeah, crazy.
I like duck feet.
Mm.
But yeah.
Pretty cool.
Very cool.
No.
But now I think they've figured out. They don't get shot at.
Figured out where to go.
No.
Yeah. No. We just.
There's music.
No.
It's not, are they all but?
Yes. I think it's half with that, isn't it?
Quiet.
He amuses himself.
Oh, he doesn't meow. You know how most cats meow? He's a less on the blue ones. And he even picks up on that. If I'm working on it, like, he sits up there and then he just, you know, he just knows. He's so funny. So
usually we have more breeze in this. Even the last few nights we've had a lot more breeze. But I think that storm this afternoon obviously just took it away.
Sun's going.
Make a wish. Make a wish. Oh no, I wouldn't live here otherwise. And all over the other side over there, that was all the botanical gardens. It's all natural, right? Don't walk through it and think you're going to see lots of flowers and stuff. That doesn't happen.
Beautiful flower displays that pop up, you know, every season.
Yeah, yeah.
No, not here. We don't have that.
Trees.
Green and green trees. And
exactly.
Green.
Lovely, interesting trees.
Yes. See? That's it.
Beautiful. My leg's getting back to normal, but I've just been doing light exercise on it. But I decided what I had to go down through here was a lunch. An AGM for Australian Society of Travel Writers and a gala dinner tonight in Melbourne or whatever, had their flights cancelled by Virgin.
Oh, don't talk about
and didn't,
like
and
that.
Didn't get them in time anyway. One of them was only getting there at 6:10 tonight.
Yeah.
And they should have got there at 8:00 this morning. But her flight's not,
her
6 a.m. flight's not going. But we've rebooked you on a flight. Rebooked you on a flight to Canberra this afternoon, which would have been late this afternoon. And you'll overnight in Canberra, and you'll get to Sydney tomorrow morning.
I do not like staying.
No, no. I'm not normal. If you haven't noticed tonight, I'm not normal anyway. But yeah, that's. I like to do something different.
Even on the bus of tourists, they say, all the 50 people, like, happy birthday to you. And once we went into the Hermitage, like our state museum of St. Petersburg, and it was early morning. I was going inside, and there's a security. Security never cares of who you are, what are you doing. And he said, hello, happy birthday. I said, what? Probably some of the my colleagues went in front of me and tell, oh, there's a girl behind me, tell her happy birthday. It was so much fun. And yeah, when you go other places and I don't know, any place is special for your birthday,
you really remember
it
a
lot. So it's really, like, cool. So I understand.
Yeah.
It means it's somewhere special.
Yeah.
You know, every birth that I've done, it's something special.
Mesdames et messieurs, I have wanted to sing a song tonight, but I fancy if I said it in French, I would get tongue-tied and you would not understand. I wanted to sing a song about Charles Aznavour, who wrote it in 1951. However, I'd much rather read Merle Harrison's version. Charles Aznavour wrote a song called Un Enfant, and Merle Harrison's translated it as a young girl. And this is from 1966. I'm not going to sing, but I might burst into song at the chorus. She left her neighbourhood, in which everyone was filthy rich. She left her parents' home and strayed with a vagabond who made vows of love she'd never heard, and she believed his every word. She left no forwarding address, just took her youth and happiness, as with the boy she vanished in the secret sweetness of his singing. A young girl of 16, child of springtime, still green, lying here by the road. He told her love demanded space, so they roamed from place to place. Although she realized she'd sinned, she threw caution to the wind as she followed him around, while he slowly dragged her down. So overpowering was her love that it made a captive of the young girl's heart and soul and mind. In other words, love drove her blind. A young girl of 16, child of springtime still green, lying here by the road. Too much emotion for a girl, she let her heart become her world. But world to God has never wrought, for the sunder, we are taught, had she been wiser, she'd have known she couldn't feed him love alone. She should have known the day would come when he would quit her just for crumbs. He needed fresh, new meat to carve, and left her heart, soul, and mind to starve. A young girl of 16, child of springtime still green, lying here by the road. Jay.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Well, I have not done this before, so I'm surprised about all this interest in sauerkraut. This is a good crowd. So I've just picked a few sections. So the first reading is a little bit about, it's 1985, so it's not, so 1985 Melbourne, Iowa, Australia, 1985. So I'm starting. Although I have traveled to big cities like Paris, London, Barcelona, and Moscow, these were visits as a tourist. Right now, I'm feeling out of place, ignorant and naive. I'm not a tourist. I'm a person who migrated to Australia. Who is going to live here, learn the language, get a job, and build a future? My hometown, Mannheim, only has 300,000 people, was built in 1607, and has an old castle and suburbs spread around the city centre. Melbourne has 10 times the population and covers a vast area. Hardly a place where you can cycle around from one suburb to the next. So one morning I spot a few of her books under the coffee table and ask Tom what they are. He laughs. They are phone directories. I can't believe it. Of course, compared to Mannheim, phone directory, this one is gigantic. I open the pages, leaf through the Millers and the Smiths, stroll across the suburbs. There is a lot to learn about the size of this place and the huge number of people living here in anonymity. I think Tom thought I would be prepared to read the phone book. I spend an afternoon studying the different surnames. Aristophanes, Baumgarten, Duon, Faulkner, Fishman, Fitzsimmons, Giannopoulos, Giordano, Ioannidis, Jovanovich, Lombardi, Markovich, McLaughlin, Nguyen, O'Donoghue, Papadakis, Petrovic, Rizzo, and Trump. Multicultural indeed. Another two phone books, the yellow pages. They are rather pale yellow and the paper is spiral thin. These are business numbers listing type of business, suburb and contact. Looks useful. To ring my parents in Germany, I have to go through an operator. Some of you might remember this in the 80s. I have to go through an operator who connects me to the overseas number I give them. Sometimes the line is very crackly. At other times you can't get through because of the high volume of callers. But hey, at least we can call. I didn't grow up with a phone. I'm not old. I'm imaginable for you, young man. So for me, this was great progress to hear my parents and sisters' voices close. Now we know how easy it is for a burglar to ransack our place. Window open, Tom smiles. Look, at least we didn't have to break a window. I'm exhausted but also relieved. Tom has his car key and the house key, both of them hanging on the rack. Right. What an adventurous weekend this was, unique. And we made it from Lockhart Gorge to Kowlak. Nobody got shot.
Some pictures, my attempt at shearing this poor sheep. As I said, I work at the College of Textiles with the wool students. And I mean, there's also London Bridge, which no longer exists, for those Malvernians or Victorians. So, well, thank you for coming. And yes,
thank you.
Oh, no, Great Western.
Oh, Great Western, that's good.
Yep, Wins Great Western.
Lovely.
Shiraz. Yeah.
Ready for food.
Lovely.
Yeah. Sorry for keep you waiting.
It's all right.
Oh, wow.
So, would you like a red wine?
Yes, please.
Well, we'll see.
Is it lamb?
It is lamb. It's our lamb grown at home. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sit down.
Yes, sit down.
Well,
please.
I wasn't sure if you like lamb or not, but.
I do.
Right. Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Right.
Peter, please join us.
I will.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Welcome.
Thank you so much.
It's so lovely to have you here.
Straight ahead of us up there too. There's someone going up that face up there.
Viewing platform at Mount Arapiles.
Beautiful. And can you distinguish by color which crop is that?
No.
No?
No, not really. No, I can't. But see the one with all the stripes? That's been harvested.
That's because you can see where the head has gone up and back around there.
Because those are a little bit brown.
Because they dry off and go very brown before they're harvested. Yep, so that's probably the beans.
Yes.
And then the straw colour over there, that'll be wheat or barley. And then next to it, in there, with all the stripes, that's been harvested already, so that could have been canola or something like that that's been harvested. And then over in the distance over there, that lighter brown colour, that could well be chickpeas or something like that. I'm not sure. Summer, there'll be no water there, it'll be very dry.
So these lakes, they're mainly supported with the underground waters?
No. They're ephemeral. When it rains, they water in them, and then in the summer they dry up. And that's miter rock there in front of it, named because from a certain angle it looks like a bishop's miter, you know, the hat the bishop wears. And up there, the building you can see up right on the highest point is a fire lookout, and it's got all the aerials on top. But during summer, there's that's manned. There's someone there all the time on the lookout for fires, because they can see so far. And we've been up in there and had a look around, and you've just got the magnificent views of the whole area. For miles and miles. To make a dam like that, they get a big excavator in, they dig it out, and then put the soil on the side of the dam, so it's always got sort of surrounded by hill things. Mm-hmm. But yeah, they just scoop it out, and then we used to have channels that used to run from the Grampians right through this area, filling up dams, but now we don't have them anymore, so any dams you see with water in them now will just have catchment from
the... We don't have any labor.
No, we don't.
And buildings over there.
That's a house and farm buildings. Yeah, that's a house.
I'm just enjoying.
Yeah. Come on, open up. That's a way.
Look at it.
Yeah. Open up. Open up. Yep.
He looks like a pine.
A pine cone.
Cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
I'm coming.
There's a blue tongue littered.
wobble up and bruise them.
Reckon. That's right. How much would be that be weighing with all of that full?
Oh, yeah, over 100 tons.
Yeah.
Why do they need fire machines? Just in case?
I would think so, just in case.
Yeah, just in case.
So you check on them?
Yeah. Well, where have we got the water in those troughs? We have to check them every couple of days because if the trough dries up.
Yeah.
Well, are any of your relatives?
Thank you. Don't say hello to me. Just say hello to Xenia.
All right. Okay. Oh, geez. This is like take four. Hello, Xenia. Lovely to meet you and lovely to learn a little bit about your country. Thank you.
We're just having an afternoon.
She can't do anything right.
No, she did.
I said hello, Xenia.
We're having an afternoon drink.
Yeah, well, I've seen take 16 on movies.
We're having an afternoon drink.
And Peter, love you too.
I know you do, my sweet.
It's not a screw, it's a bayonet.
Okay.
So you've got to go push up and push up. Push
and then
up.
Twist.
Push it up. Yep.
Different.
Push it up and clockwise.
That should be it.
No.
It's not a screw. She's screwing it.
No.
You push it up. And
find the other globe, please.
Find the gap. You keep spinning until you find the gap.
The globe's
and then
all right. It's not the globe.
Oh, okay, it's not the globe.
All right.
It says it's not the globe.
Right.
Down.
Yeah, correct.
Okay, Xenia, you can come down.
Sorry. Oh,
no. Mm.
Why is it? It must be something to do.
Let me have a look.
All right.
It must be just a making
proper
comment.
Oh, H and S.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, quick.
I'll hold you.
Oh,
ooh.
Right.
Yeah.
The electricals are broken.
Yeah.
Hey! Look at that. And we didn't electroplate you.
No. There we go.
So the story on the light globes is, down at the next door neighbours, they had a 32 volt diesel lighting plant there that they used for lighting and power before the SEC came through. And it just sat in the shed idle for years after the power came through. And I bought the lighting plant. I went down to pick it up. And up on the roof I see a couple of boxes on a couple of planks in between the rafters. And I got them down, and all the 32 volt globes from the farm were all in there. There were about 50 globes there. So we've got an endless supply of 32 volt globes. Well, not endless, but we'll never see them out.
That's
excellent. Some of them were really old too. They were a very different sort of a light globe.
Marvellous. Connie, say hello. Connie?
I'm sick of that.
Connie?
Sick of being a film star.
Yeah.
Oh, good work.
Yep. Yeah, the wildfield, yep. Yes.
Oh.
Yes, this is Rachel's wine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Taste. Are you going to taste it?
So have you got a glass, Steve?
I have a glass, Paul.
Did you take the others in? I have one there.
No, that is yours.
Okay, I'll get you one.
Beautiful.
Yeah, okay.
Lovely.
Thank you.
Yeah, when we were at her place and she showed us around, they now got this machine that they put the bottles, they go into the bell, something on top is poured the wine or whatever, the liquid, and it goes out. So they just need to close it and put it into the box. They told me they got this thing
it's
only recently.
Okay, yes, I've been doing that only in hand. Mm. Yeah, we have been there. But
thanks, Paul.
I haven't seen that. Yeah. You know. Yummy. It's lovely wine.
Pardon? Are they?
A bottle. Thanks, Paul.
Are they the first in the family who started like the wine business?
Okay. I'm going to finish now.
Please. Help yourself.
Stop filming. Let's go to eat.
Help yourself to some chops, but don't take the burnt ones because they're Peter's.
Those two on the end are probably a little bit.
Thank you, everyone. Sunday evening dinner.
He used it too much. But I unfortunately can't do the sobrage. Oh, I've got glasses. I'm sorry, I can't see. Because it'd be too dangerous for all the passers-by. Now this is a Vermentino. From Myattsfield?
Yes, the Vermentino.
This is the Vermentino from Myattsfield. It's a method traditional Vermentino 2022. It's an interesting grape. One doesn't always, I haven't seen a sparkling Vermentino anywhere. It's usually Pinot and a Chardonnay. But they take risks. There you go.
Look at the great excavation of life. It's now got piles right up to ground level and above. And so they're about to seal. I don't know what they're going to do. If it's a garage, I don't know. Underground parking, maybe?
On the
26th floor,
isn't
it?
26.
On the 26th floor?
Yeah. Now that's made by my daughter. You've met Rachel over
there.
Yeah.
Yes, that's
in
a beautiful champagne, yeah.
Yes.
We've opened one bottle with Margaret last time.
Okay.
Well, I don't know, maybe it's a different one.
It's a different one, yeah.
Okay, good.
Vermentino. Oh. That's the grape variety. Oh, well done.
Cheers.
Cheers.
On top of the world.
Oh, yeah.
Cheers.
Thank you,
Kaylin. And would you like to take a little seat in? Thank you, honey.
Sit down.
And I'll put the camera away for a while.
Okay.
Too hard.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Actually, I might
help yourself to salad.
Mmm. And is this another vintage?
No, this is not a Myers Field one. This is an Australian one.
Mm-hmm.
Riesling. From, I think, I haven't got my glasses on, I think it's McLaren Vale. It's in South Australia.
Oh.
Okay, now.
I'll put it back in the fridge because it's so hot, it's warm enough.
Yes. Say hi, Zinda. Good.
And
dining.
Hi.
Dining on the 26th floor. Very good dinner, honey.
Helen.
Mm-hmm. I haven't got any dessert, I'm afraid, not tonight.
That's all right.
I might make.
We've had too many desserts at
Elizabeth's. Oh, wow.
Elizabeth made a really splendid, tiny little individual cheesecake last night.
Oh, yeah.
With strawberries and blueberries.
Oh, lovely. Lovely.
Small presents for you.
Oh.
From Russia.
Oh,
I'm
from
sorry.
Russia.
Yeah. Sorry, this doesn't look good because three weeks in my suitcase. So it's a brioche candies. It's with pine cone and pine nuts.
Oh, yep.
They're not very sweet, so more healthy rather than
sweet.
Oh,
that's good. Yeah.
And inside there's some herbal tea.
Oh.
I don't know, you may add to your everyday tea or just, I don't know, do it on its own. So it's very healthy. It's from the mountains in the Siberia.
Right. Okay.
Or Russia. Inside there's also handmade soap. Which you
lovely.
Can use.
Yes.
And this little thing is, I hope you're reading still.
Yeah.
And there's a little bookmark.
Oh,
it's
lovely.
For the next year symbol dragon.
Oh, yep.
And
yep.
a little bell.
Oh, lovely.
So it was made in St Petersburg with the silver masters. So.
Oh, thank you. That's gorgeous.
Yeah.
The year of the dragon and the lovely.
So thank you very much for having me and showing me Australia. It'll be a little reminder.
That's so sweet.
That's lovely. Oh, that's lovely. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much. And this is the
So there's soap and tea inside.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
I'll have a look at that.
But be careful, maybe tea also is kind of a, because it's a paper.
Uh-huh. Oh, good. That says tea, does it?
Yeah, it's different.
It's a bit scented. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you see this
little
pepper. Yeah.
Yep, that's all right. I can stick something over that.
Mm-hmm.
So
oh,
that'll be interesting.
Labaznik, I don't know. Then raspberry, kipre, bushuk.
Oh, there's some soap. Mm,
yeah.
I like soap. Oh, that's so good. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. This one should be made out of clay.
Clay?
Like a blue clay, which is very good for your skin.
Okay.
And we usually put lots of mask on the face,
okay.
made out of the blue clay. So this is the
soap. Oh, so this is just
it.
For your face, is
mm-hmm.
it? Okay, good. I'll do
face,
that.
Hands.
I need everything I can get for my face at the moment. It's gone to the pack. Oh, that's lovely. And I'm very keen to try the tea.
Yeah.
Might have some tonight. Do you
good.
Drink tea?
I do tea, yeah.
Okay.
We can try it together.
Yeah.
Too bad it's getting a little bit.
Yeah, that's all right. I'll put some sticky tape over it.
Okay.
You seem to sleep reasonably well. Oh. And you were aware that I got petrol. We
but yeah, you know, when you sleep but you don't sleep, you hear things, but your mind is half asleep
half
anyway.
There.
Yeah.
I think there was a bit of recovery there that night.
Mm-hmm.
So
probably I might go to bed early tonight as well.
So we're having the last of the Freya and whatever. And saying thank you, Helen, it's been a lovely meal.
Yeah, thank you.
Watching the planes come in. Here we go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cheers.
Bon appetit.
Bon appetit. Cheers.
Cheers. Metropolis.
Yeah, when we first came here, I mean, there were no houses over here.
Really?
No. We just, I always remember looking out to the hills.
Yes,
we were sitting here. You know how I was saying that there were two of your glasses missing from the boat? They're in here. You only need four on the boat.
Yes.
And so this is one of them. Look how clear.
It still is.
Yeah.
Gosh.
Yeah.
Cheers. Oh, cheers.
Yeah. Cheers. Cheers.
That's it.
We can do one.
doing everything that you do for me.
Cheers. We don't know.
It's the French who are very...
Oh, I'm sure French will be too hard.
That's my original. Yes. Well, there we go.
Le bon appetit.
Yes, bon appetit. Yeah. How do we say that in Russian?
Приятного аппетита.
Ah, приятного аппетита.
Ah, very good.
Oh, Ellie, you're so good on languages.
Oh, no, yeah, I just heard you. Yes.
Lovely. Oh, that's good. Here we go.
Yeah, I was reading about this island. I want to see a coral. White ones.
Yes, you can just point it out.
So we're paying and we're going to come out here and then go around the back of Raymond Island, where you saw the koalas, across Lake King, and around past Meta, that's a very flash little village, and then along the Mia to go across to Lake's entrance. And here is where the entrance is to the sea. So we'll see that as we go across.
Thank you. And you'll need to sit down.
Boat in the water today, we actually had to go in with the car into the water quite a bit because there was so much flood coming.
These ones definitely look taller.
Yes. Beautiful beach and sand dunes. Will we go?
What is it with the sand, Ksenia?
It makes a sound.
With the sand? The sand. Did I say sand or sound? Yes.
Yeah.
Do you want to try doing it? And let's see if we can pick it up.
Okay.
Ahoy. That's it.
You have to be a year in advance to book those.
Have a good swim.
Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Good.
And there's a nice breeze.
Good. That's lovely. Thank you.
real money. Yes, I think they've intentionally cut things down.
And there.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Please be seated.
Did St. George and Paulette Street for those old houses.
Right.
So I made it to the oldest houses in the city,
mm-hmm.
which dates back to 1880.
And you went on the train, the
Actually, no.
Oh.
Because I missed it.
All right.
I was just waving to its back.
Mm-hmm.
And the next one, it was saying 41 minutes. But on the website, they say every 15 minutes.
Yeah.
So I was just walking.
Eight.
It was a really good experience, but they didn't allow us to take photos.
That's
strange.
But I did anyway.
Yeah.
But I don't know, with flash, okay, but when you're just making a video, I don't see how it affects the penguins.
No,
I wouldn't have thought that the penguins going to be afraid.
No.
No, they were not. And it's the period of matching. So they were making...
Mating.
Yeah, mating, yeah. And they were doing such funny sounds when they came back home. And I don't know, they start to... Most of them start to be in pairs.
Yeah.
Oh. They're making this... Oh, very interesting sounds. What a fall of my makeup.
But anyway, we've just had dessert, so this is lovely.
Yeah, very lovely dessert, lovely evening.
That's very good. Goodbye.
How cute.
Bye.